Hello and welcome to lesson 13. Now, in this lesson, it's going to be more of a hands-on and practical challenge. I want you to try to build this app on your own. Now, you have all the skills you need based on lessons 1 to 12, and this exercise is going to be a great way to reinforce what you've learned and also to identify any gaps in your knowledge at this point so that we can go and review it and also go and figure out what it is that you need to get up to speed before continuing. Okay, so let me just walk through this app. You've got a title, you've got number of credits, you've got some images, and when you hit this button, it merely randomizes the images. If they don't match, then you're going to lose credits, but however, if you get three matching ones, which I can't seem to do right now, then you would gain credits. So this is very much like the war card game, except that now there are three things that you randomize instead of two. And the image assets are in the description in a link, so you can make sure you grab those. Then you'll have everything you need. Whether you think this is too easy or if it's too hard, either way, I highly recommend that you try it because it's really the best way to learn. Even if you get stuck, when you look at the solution and you figure out how to overcome that obstacle that you're stuck on, it's going to be extra meaningful and it's going to really help commit it to memory. And this belief about hands-on learning is due to my own failure in the beginning when I tried to learn iOS. So this is not just, you know, something I read or something I heard. This is from my own personal experience that there's nothing else that can replace it. It's the best way to learn. So long story short, give this challenge a try. We have a great forum that if you are viewing this on YouTube or on our website, feel free to post in the app development section for hints or, you know, if you want just a little guidance on the right direction so that you can complete it, post here. If you are in CWC Plus and you have access to the course students area, then post in the Swift UI section in there and we'll support you there as well. So that being said, good luck with the challenge and I'll see you in the next lesson.